Ever since I bought the Instant Pot, I haven't made sushi rice any other way. It produces absolutely perfect rice with the least amount of work. Of course, the same exact method works in any rice cooker. If you don't have one and want a stovetop version, check out the link below this video. Okay, so first we need good rice. I realize that you can buy something called sushi rice in every supermarket these days, but please realize that not all rice is created equal. Even the most expensive rice is not that pricey compared to, say, meat or fish, and it tastes so much better than the cheapest kind. Koshihi Kari is a popular Japanese rice variety. I've tried it from many different brands, and it is always good. If you are not an expert on Japanese cuisine and don't know what else to look for on the package, look for that. I really like this brand. I get it at Wegmans, but it's also available on Amazon. I'll link to a few good brands on Amazon in the description below. I went back and forth between measuring rice by volume and by weight. In my previous sushi rice video, I did it by weight. But I've noticed that in real life, I rarely weigh my rice. The good news is that neither rice nor water are compressible the way flour is, so measuring them by volume isn't a problem. Since I make so much rice, I like a formula that is easy to remember. And sushi rice by volume couldn't be easier. It's 1:1. So for 1.5 cups of rice, scooped and leveled, no heaping cups, please, I'll need 1.5 cups of water. My measuring cups have a handy dandy little halfway line, so I can get a pretty accurate half cup with a full cup measure. But if your measuring cups don't have that feature, I don't recommend eyeballing half a cup. Get the half cup measure and do it right. Put the rice into your Instant Pot insert and cover it with cold water by about an inch. Gently rub the rice grains for 30 seconds or so with your hands to get rid of excess starch. Washing rice before cooking is a must, otherwise the rice will come out too starchy and the water measurement will be way off. 1:1 ratio assumes you're starting with wet rice. When the water looks milky white, pour it off. When I used to make sushi rice only on occasion, I would dump it into a fine mesh strainer to drain it because I was worried that it would all fall into the sink. But if you slow down toward the end, the rice stays put with no problems. Don't sweat each drop at this point because we're going to rinse one more time. Add fresh water, rub the rice one more time, and pour it off. Though I'll confess that when I'm in a rush, I skip the second wash. Whether you wash your rice once or twice, on the last wash you need to get all the water out. Once your pot is parallel to the counter, don't tip it further or the rice will fall out. Just let the water pour out slowly until the stream turns into drips and the drips slow down. Now we need to add the water that will cook the rice in. That's the water we need to measure. I use the same dry measuring cup for water that I use for rice. If I fill it to the very top, it's quite accurate. Swirl the pot a few times to distribute the rice evenly. Wipe the lip of your pot to make sure you'll get a good seal with your lid. Put the insert into the Instant Pot. Make sure the gasket is in the lid and that the pressure release knob is set to sealing. Screw on the lid and press the rice button. Keep warm automatically comes on, but I turn it off because I like to dress my rice shortly after it's done. If you want to cook your rice later, after you press the rice button, press the delay start button and enter how much time the Instant Pot should wait before it starts cooking. It's way better to delay the cooking than to keep the rice on keep warm cycle for hours. It usually takes me around 30 to 40 minutes from the moment I start the cooking until the rice is done. It takes 10 to 15 minutes for the pot to just to pressurize. Once it's pressurized, it starts to count down 12 minutes on low pressure. Once those 12 minutes are up, your rice is not done. You need to wait for the pressure to drop naturally, which will take another 10 to 15 minutes. If you open the pot as soon as 12 minutes are up, you'll get undercooked rice. While our rice is cooking, let's make the seasoning vinegar. You don't need to dress this rice with anything if you don't want to. I serve it undressed as a side dish all the time. But for sushi dishes and poke bowls, I really like to dress it. After all, sushi means vinegared rice. We'll need 50 grams of rice wine vinegar. Make sure you get plain and not seasoned vinegar for this. 25 grams of granulated sugar and 6 grams of salt. I do it by weight so that I don't have to dirty measuring spoons, and also because 50, 25, 6 is easy for me to remember. But if volume is easier, do that. Just keep in mind that if you're measuring salt by volume, you'll need different number of teaspoons depending on which salt you use, because different salts have different crystal shape, size, and density. Mix the vinegar, sugar, and salt together, but don't worry if they don't dissolve immediately. By the time your rice finishes cooking, there'll be one big happy family, or at least close to it. When the pressure indicator falls back down, your rice is ready to dress. If you missed the moment when the pressure indicator dropped, don't worry. Your rice can happily wait in a sealed pot for quite some time after the pressure indicator falls. Open the pot, but be careful not to pour the water that condensed on the lid back into the pot. Keep it in the lid and discard. Give the vinegar a final stir until everything dissolves and dump it into the rice. Use a flat big spoon. I use the spatula that came with my Instant Pot to cut through the rice. The goal is to separate the grains without smooshing them. If we stir aggressively using a circular motion, we'll end up with a mush. Once in a while, scoop up the rice from around the sides and keep on cutting. When you don't see any more clumps of rice and the vinegar is evenly distributed and absorbed, you're done. When in doubt, taste the rice. I taste it even when I'm not in doubt, because who can resist freshly made sushi rice? If you are not using the rice immediately, cover it with a damp paper towel and it will wait for up to 2 hours. But I like to use my sushi rice while it's still very warm. My kids' favorite weekday breakfast is this rice with sliced raw salmon and the soy reduction. In case you think that I'm some good mom who wakes up at 5 a.m. to make this stuff, sorry to disillusion you. I am a lazy bum when it comes to breakfast. The rice gets started the night before. The salmon is sliced, portioned, and frozen about once a month or so. And all I have to do the night before is get it out of the freezer and put it into the fridge. The soy reduction lasts in the fridge forever, so I make it like, I don't know, twice a year. The morning part of all this is as easy as Cheerios with milk. But it does require more planning than that, and that's why it doesn't happen every morning. By the way, the link for my soy reduction is below. Next week, we'll put our sushi rice to work and make my favorite summer meal, the poke bowl. So stay tuned, don't forget to subscribe, hit that little bell button for notifications. And if you are ever in the Boston area, maybe I'll see you in one of my classes.